Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI release December 2023 as part of Catch Up with Nags series. Probably this is going to be our last video for this year. And obviously, I didn't make much videos during this year 2023 due to other commitments. And I'm really want to inform you like next year, it's going to be a lot of Azure videos and especially focusing on Fabric. That is for sure. So you can expect more videos compared to this year in 2024, and that will be primarily focusing on Fabric. With this note, let's begin our today's topic. So what are the features I like as part of December 2023? So reporting, more styling options for column and bar charts, extended customization for data labels, and the connectivity, one leg data hub for Power BI desktop. Earlier in previous release, as of for November 2023, you will have this preview features for the one leg data hub, and once you installed December version, then you will get this preview will be removed. So you will have, it is basically like it is generally available, the one leg data hub connectivity. That is what this is all about. Then services, alerting on Power BI reports with data activator. There is a alerting feature already exist from the Power BI service, but this alerting is within the reports itself. Okay, that is the concept I really liked. And developers perspective, it's a Git integration conflict resolution. So you have a workspace, or editing some objects in that workspace, and same thing you have edited in the repos as well. So there will be a conflict for the same object. If you edit in workspace as well as report, there will be a conflict. So now Power BI team or the Fabric team, whatever you call, they have given a way to resolve those conflicts. That is the overall about this release. And I mean basically this is not the overall release. As you might aware, I mentioned that the top features I like, there are a lot of other features that you can go and check it out as part of this release. One thing to highlight in the Microsoft website itself, what they mentioned is like this release has some issues, not yet been released yet. I'm recording this on 17th of December 2023. They released on 12th December, so I'm waiting for last 5 days. I didn't get any updates. Even today I tried, so this I'm not able to demonstrate any of this skills, I mean the features, whatever they have released right now. So what a key feature I want to show you, so I will walk you through here. As I mentioned, the features I like is like more styling option for column and bar charts. So you can see here, so more styling options, this is available for column and bar charts, where you can have a transparency and you can split the bars over like this, and you can go through these options. So the main purpose is to know you can have more styling options in your bar and column charts. That is what I want to highlight. Then coming to here, extended customization for data labels. Earlier you don't have option to have multiple labels. So let's say you have this measure, right, cost by campaign type. So you can see only the cost here. You can add another measure over here. So right now you have option to do so. You can have multiple measures and then you can customize the labels. That is the feature I like the most. So these are the two features I like in case of reporting. And when it comes to data connector, one leg, as I said, now it's generally available. Earlier version you will see the preview option over here. So that is the second thing. And alerts, let's go to alerts. Where is that? It will be in the service. Let's see here. Yes, that is present as alert, but usually these alerts are in the services. That's why I categorized under service tab. That's okay. So now you might have aware, after the fabric release, you have a new tool called data activator. So now this is alerting is part of data activator. So Power BI users have been asking alert capabilities within the report. Data activator is here to help. So we can create alert from the report itself. You can see this is the report, and this will be saved under the data activator. So that is the whole concept of alerts. Then one last thing I mentioned over here is like Git integration conflict resolution. Let's go to that part as well. This is under developers. So basically, like as I mentioned earlier, but these are the new features recently announced in last few months, last 6-4 months. If you are not following last few months updates, you may not get what I'm talking about. So go through those things as well. Basically, now you can integrate workspaces into Git integration so that your code will be moved from repositories using Git, right? So you can save the Power BI as a file format, then you can store all your objects in the Git repository. From Git repository, you can deploy it here so that both will be sync once you check in a checkout process. Basically, it's maintaining your Power BI file in a repos so that this will be synced. So what happened right now here is like there will be a possibility like someone edits directly instead of going to the Git, and someone has edited in the Git as well. So there will be a conflict between the version in the workspace and version whatever in the repositories. So this will have a conflict. So now Power BI team has given resolving the conflict. These are the manual things you need to do either case. So that is what this change about. This is important feature when you implement integrate the Power BI things in the Git, then obviously all these things you need to aware. That's it about this release. I hope you understand what are the different things released as part of this release and what are the features I liked. And finally, before closing this video, this channel contains a lot of free contents. Utilize this content, share this channel with friends and colleagues, and do remember that data is your asset.